Tracy Davis. Good evening, good night, good morning, whenever you're actually tuning in. I'm so excited to be able to welcome you to the zone. Welcome, 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 welcome. You know, every time I come on, I start clapping. I'm setting the atmosphere, shifting my mood, shifting your mood, helping you get ready to receive some information. So that's why this lady comes on clapping. I'm a business and success coach, and I come to you. We're going to be making some adjustments, but right now we've been coming Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, hanging out with you to give you business and success tips, right? My goal whenever I come on is to encourage you, to inspire you, and to push you into your destiny. Hey, hey, hey. Yes, I'm back tonight. Last night was crazy, I think, for everybody. So I just did not feel like I wanted to bring you guys that kind of energy, but I am here. So hey, hey, hey. Thank you so much for being here tonight. Hello to everyone. Thanks for the waves. Thanks for the hearts. Thank you for tagging and sharing, okay? Make sure you check out the link in my bio. I always tell you guys this because I always have goodies there that I want to make sure that you guys get a chance to take advantage of, okay? So from the courses to my one-on-one coaching, I'm not going to be doing that much longer as far as the one-on-one. I have quite a few big projects that are coming up, and so I won't have as much time. I always get all sweaty. I won't have as much time for the one-on-one, so take advantage of that now while I still have some slots, okay? So I'm super excited, and thank you for understanding why I wasn't here tonight. I really, really appreciate that because I do value you guys when you show up and you pull on me and get information, and then more than that, you implement it. It makes me feel really, really good, okay? So again, our topic for tonight is going to be on goal setting. We've had some really good topics this week. If you've been joining me in the mornings, of course, I give a word for the day. We stay on for about 10, 15 minutes or whatever, and then we come in the evening and we talk more business types of things. I am a business coach, right? And so that's what my goal is when I come on. I want to help you with your business. If you have a business, if you've been thinking about a business, just to kind of give you some ideas, give you some inspiration, and hopefully if you want to go deeper, you'll want to take one of my courses or get some one-on-one coaching, okay? All right, all right, all right. So anyway, we are going to talk a little bit, like I said, about goal setting. So the first thing that you want to do when you are talking about goal setting is the beginning of the year. Even though I don't know, like for you, for me, it feels like, man, it doesn't even feel like the new year anymore. After yesterday, it feels like, man, feels like the extension of 2020, right? That's what it feels like. But we're going to move away from feelings and just keep our focus, right? That's what our word for today was, just to keep our focus. So let's make a decision. That's the first thing. Whenever you're goal setting, you need to make a decision, okay? Decide what it is that you want to run after. Whatever that is, okay? So I am very, very goal-oriented. Typically, people that hang out with me, they know I'm always working on something. That is how I function. I feel driven to succeed. So I always have something written down. I always have something that I'm running for. And usually, if a person that I'm talking to doesn't have goals, the conversation is probably not going to be too long because that's how I function, right? I'm not much into small talk, right? I'm into people that are driven and doing some great things, and I want to hear all about it, okay? So we want to make a decision, decide what it is that you're actually wanting, okay? And you don't want to plan too far out in advance. You know, a lot of people say, where would you like to see yourself in 5 years? That's great, but what I'm talking about is something a little bit more specific. I want you to do a goal for this year. Then I want you to take that goal and break it down, you know, into like quarters, 6 months, where you want to be, 90 days, where do you want to be, next week, where do you want to be, okay? Because that way you can kind of stay on top of things, okay? My God, it got really, really hot in here fast, okay? Second thing you want to do is to write it down. You don't want to just say you have a goal. You need to make sure that it's written down, okay? So we've talked about vision boards this week. We've talked about affirmations this week, right? So you need to make sure that these things that I've been sharing with you, that they are truly written down, okay? Written down, not just someplace that you'll write them down and not look at them again, but written down in a place that you can visit them, that you can see them every single day. So if you were to come in my office, you would see that I have things all over. I have whiteboards, I have poster board, I have notebooks, things that are written down so that I'm constantly triggered as to what it is that I'm working on, okay? So you wanna make sure that they're written down. There is a statistic that says 42% of people that write their goals down are actually the ones that achieve them, okay? So if you don't write them down, I mean, my goodness, you're actually going against the grain, going against what's good for you, okay? So you wanna actually write them down. Now, I actually saw something that said Grant Cardone, those of you who know who that is, this big real estate mogul, he writes his goals down twice a day. Once when he gets up in the morning and once before he goes to bed. That's how serious he is about actually, let me wipe myself real quick. I thought I had a towel or something, but I don't. And hubby's downstairs. It is warm in here. Oh my God, what is happening? Anyway, 42% are more likely to achieve their goals. So Grant Cardone said, you know what? If I'm going to write them down, I'm gonna write it down in the morning and I'm gonna write it down in the evening. How many of you would be willing to commit to something like that? If you're not gonna do it twice a day, would you be committed to do it at least once a day? Some people don't do it even once a year. So my God, can you imagine if you did it once a day? So that's something I'm planning to do as far as I'm planning in the morning, write the goals down, right? Not only in the morning, but also before you go to bed. 6 most important things to do list. That's what I've been trained since the mid 90s. Write down 6 things that you can focus on for the day and check them off as you go. Okay. Hey everybody, I see you guys waving. Thank you so much for hopping on. You all are such sweethearts to be here. I hope you're getting some value. For those of you that do not know me, my name is Tracy Davis. I'm a business and success coach, and I come on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern to hang out with you guys, give you some business and success tips to help you, to inspire you, encourage you, and push you into your destiny. Okay. So thank you. I see some new faces on here, and I'm hoping that you all are sharing and that you all are enjoying the information that I'm sharing. Make sure you go back and look over some of the older recordings that I have before I take them down on IGTV Live. We have quite a bit of information that I've been able to share this week, okay? All right, so we're going to make a decision, deciding exactly what it is that we're working on. I think that's really something that we all have to do. What is it specifically that you want, okay? You got to know what that is. Then you want to write it down. Now, this can be kind of controversial where it says to share your goals. Now, you do want to share your goals, but you want to make sure you're sharing your goal with someone that you trust. Share it with someone that will be a believer in you, right? Share it with someone that will encourage you. That's where a mentor comes in. That's where a coach comes in. That's where a friend comes in, right? But you have to make sure that friend is someone that can handle your shine, that can handle where you're going. Because a lot of times when you start to share your goals, right, people get intimidated by that because that's not the norm. As much as we hear about personal development, as much as we hear about write down your goals, write the vision, make it plain, we hear about it, most people do not. And so when you decide to be different, when you decide to say, hey, this is what I'm working on for 2021, I don't care how crazy it's been, I don't care what the media is saying or whatever, people will look at you funny, right? And it can discourage you if you're not really strong in your belief of yourself. Like, I'm pretty strong, right? Sometimes it'll discourage me. I'll get a little like, man, I can't believe they're not rooting for me. But after a while, I snap out of that thing and say, you know what? I believe in me. I know what I'm capable of, right? Now, I was listening to somebody the other day and they were talking about how they don't know how to celebrate themselves, right? And I'm getting a little ahead of myself, but I want to talk about that because I say this all the time. Sometimes you have to pause for the cause and read your own resume. And I'll say it again. You guys will probably tune in and hear me saying it all the time. You have to remind yourself of how amazing you are, because most of the time people around you will not remind you of how amazing you are. Either they're intimidated or either they're used to you, right? So you can't let familiarity keep you from going to that next level. I hope I'm helping somebody tonight. That's why occasionally, not from a narcissistic standpoint, not from a standpoint where you're just so stupidly in love with yourself, but from the standpoint of, I gotta boost myself up. I gotta pump myself up, right? You have to do that. You were here this morning, Danny. Awesome. Thank you so, so much. I'm so glad you're following me as well. Praise God. Oh, awesome, awesome. So guys, when you are sharing your goals, make sure they meet the criteria of, this is a person that will root for me, will push me, will encourage me, right? And celebrate me with me when I achieve the goal, okay? So, so, so important. So that's who you want to share it with. Now, a lot of times we'll say share it because you know, if you're working on something, you're very deeply into it, your family needs to know what's going on so they don't feel like you're ignoring them. So that's what we mean by that when I say share your goal. But don't just go and blast it everywhere else. You know, I like to move in silence. You'll never know what I'm working on until it's almost finished or finished, right? Because there is a such thing as negative energy. There are some people that are flat out haters, shade throwers, all that kind of stuff. And we'll have time for it, right? So have the goals, write the goals, share the goals, but make sure you share them with the right people, okay? The next thing that you want to do is get into the details. Once you have that goal, you want to make sure that you have some daily activities to push you towards making it happen, okay? A lot of times you'll be so disappointed, and I can say this from experience, that if you didn't revisit it, you'll be so disappointed to say, man, it's the end of the month and I haven't met my goal. But you can trace it back to say, I didn't really revisit it. I didn't really have anything daily that I was working on, okay? So it's going to be so important that you have some daily goals to keep you focused so that you'll stay focused, so that you're not distracted nor discouraged, okay? So I hope you're getting some value there, all right? The next thing that you're going to want to do, let me go ahead and I have some notes here for you guys, is you want to make sure that you show up and that you're making some progress, okay? And knowing that the results are going to come. Sometimes you can get discouraged when you have a goal and you're like, man, nothing is happening. But never ever despise a small beginning. Always realize that if you're going live, that's seed, right? That's working towards something. If you are DMing people, if you're answering questions, right? If you started working on a book or working on a checklist or whatever, I'm not sure what it is that you guys are working on. May have a new formula for some skincare. I don't know, but you have to start working on those things little by little. First the blade, right? First, you gotta have a first step. A lot of times people are looking at someone's highlight reels. We see this all the time, but we're not really knowing their backstory. They don't tell you how hard it was. They don't tell you that they were broke, right? They don't tell you that a lot of times they're living off the residue of previous success, right? So they have the bag, they'll have the shoes, but you don't even know that they're broke, right? So I need you to make sure that you understand that, hey, every day I'm doing something towards my goal and that I am making progress. Matter of fact, you would need to say that. That would be one of my affirmations. I am making progress. I am goal oriented. I am making great things happen, right? I am moving and shaking and going towards my goal. So that's important. Then you want to make sure that you keep going, okay? Keep going no matter what, no matter if it's hard, no matter if you feel like, wow, nothing is happening. Keep going. And then you want to celebrate your wins. Okay, have something that you said, when I accomplish this, and I don't care what the goal is, have a way to celebrate. Okay, I love getting massages. My God, I miss going to the spa and all of that. As soon as things clear up, I will be there probably every week. But, you know, have something that says, you know, I'm going to purchase this, or I'm going to visit this, or do, you know, something that will celebrate you. And then if you can get somebody else to celebrate with you, that is even better, okay? So let's get a little bit more specific since we have a little bit more time. When you're doing these goals, you wanna make sure that they are SMART goals, okay? SMART goals. SMART, what do I mean by that? This is an acronym. Number one, you wanna make sure that they are specific. So get as specific as possible. We don't wanna say, I'm gonna lose weight. When you're specific, you'll say, I'm going to weigh 135 pounds. And then so you'll be able to say specifically what it is that you're going for. My goal is to weigh, right? Write that down. Not I'm going to lose weight, okay? All right. Second thing is you want to make sure it's measurable, okay? So if we're still using the losing weight as a goal, you can measure it by saying, this is how much I weigh right now, and I'm going to weigh, you know, have lost 10 pounds in 30 days, for an example, okay? Because we're writing these goals down, we're being specific, and now we are measuring them, okay? And then you wanna make sure that the goal is action-oriented, okay? So you're gonna use words like reduce, you're gonna use words like save, you're gonna use words like exercise, right? Things that indicate movement, okay? So that is what you're wanting to do. And then you're gonna wanna make sure that the goal is realistic. You don't wanna make it so big that you get discouraged because it's like, oh my gosh, can I do that in 12 months? But you don't wanna make it so small that you're not moved by it either, okay? So you wanna have a happy median, making sure that it is realistic. I have fallen to the trap of making my goals so big, it's like I was discouraged because like, there's no way I could do it, right? So make sure you look for that happy median, make sure that they are smart, make sure they're measurable, make sure there's action put behind it, okay? And make sure it's realistic, okay? And then make sure you give it a time. Don't just say one day. One day is not on the calendar. Some days not on the calendar. We only have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So choose a day, okay? Choose a day, write that down, and guess what? We never change the goal. We can just change the date. But I need you to at least start with a date, okay? So we've covered quite a bit. The main thing that I want you guys to get and to really, really understand is that we have to have some goals. You're not going to achieve the success that you desire and deserve if you don't have goals that are specific, if they're not written down, if you're not excited about it, if you're not motivated about it, right? And if you're not sharing it with people that are also dreamers. I like to lock arms with people that are similar. Well, you know, you got to have somebody that's either pulling you up, right? Because they've been there, done that. That's where a coach or a mentor comes in. Then you got to have somebody that you're running with, y'all on the same level. And then guess what? You should also be reaching back to bring somebody else with you, okay? That's the kind of person that achieves great things in life because they're thinking about growing, they're also thinking about running with someone, and they're also thinking about bringing somebody else with them, okay? So I want you to be focused, I want you to be goal-oriented, I want you to have an amazing year this year, and with everything that I've shared all week, guys, you should be bosses. You should boss up for real, okay? So again, I've given you quite a bit of information this week. Tomorrow night, I won't be on here because that's date night with my hubby, but I'll be back on Monday night at 9 p.m. to continue in our quest. We're going to go a little bit more deeper, talking about some things that you need to have in place to have a business online. That's my area of expertise. I like to build businesses online so that I can work anywhere I want as long as I have some Wi-Fi. So let me see what the comments are real quick. Action-oriented. I love that action-oriented as well. I've heard attainable, but never action-oriented. Yes, yes, yes. You want to make sure that you're using words like that. Very good. I was here this morning. Okay, you're amazing. So glad I'm following you. Thank you, Danny, so much. All right, I see quite a few new faces on here. Hey to everybody. Thanks for understanding for me not being here last night. So are there any questions, you all? We've talked about gratitude this week. We've talked about staying focused this week. We've talked about integrity this week, right? Because we want to be people that are integrous as we're building our businesses. There's so many people online that are telling lies. I want to make sure that you guys know that when you come here, you can trust me. I'm telling you things that I'm using in my life and have helped not only people that I love, but people that I coach all over the years. So I take it and then I share it with you guys, okay? So again, we want to be people that have attitudes of gratitude. We want to make sure that we have our affirmations, and we want to make sure that we're saying them every single day. I like to say them as soon as I get up in the morning, right? I am powerful. I am strong. I'm happy and grateful now that new, excited professionals join my business every day. I say things like that to set my day, right? You want to do that. Then you want to make sure that you're writing these things down, scripting your life. Oh, I can't wait. Next week, we're going to be talking about scripting our lives. I'm telling you, everything that you want to see manifest in your life, there's a method and a strategy to getting it done, okay? So God bless you guys. Thanks so much for hanging out. I hope you got some value. I hope you'll share this, and I hope you'll show up again. I will be here in the morning to give you some motivation. There will be a word for the day, but I won't be here tomorrow night. So just to make sure you understand, tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. Eastern, I'll be right back here, okay? But I won't be here tomorrow night, okay? So God bless. Thanks for hanging out. I hope that you got some value, and I'll see you in the morning. Good morning, guys. Thanks for hanging out. Set some goals. Let me know what's going on. DM me and let me know you are implementing. You're taking action. God bless. Have a good night. Hey, 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 hey. I like this. Come on.